wonderful opportunity and privilege to be in this high altar and to fellowship with my brothers and sisters in 1, 2, 3 generations today. The 45 minutes that I've spent in your midst this morning has been the most fulfilling of my life. The atmosphere was charged, and I know that the Holy Spirit is in our midst. There is no reason why anybody in this congregation should lack. There is no reason why anybody in this congregation should be sick. Because when your presence is sent to heaven, God descends, and then it is your opportunity to whisper your prayers to Him. And with assurance and faith, all the bodies that came to this church today will be lifted in Jesus' name. Yeah. So if you are a Jew or a Bible, and you have the opportunity and privilege to make a donation or assist for the work of God to make progress, it is an opportunity for you to attract more blessings to yourself. So there is no gainsaying or preaching about it, or asking the governor whether he will listen or not. It is an order. It is a mandate. It is something that must be done. Because if I fail to do it, somebody else will do it. On this note, I want us to reflect a little about what I've been asked to say today. Leadership in the fear of God. Leadership in the fear of God. I am here today as governor for two reasons only. The first reason is that my story and ascension as governor of Bible States will bring hope to all poor families in Bible State and in Nigeria. Do you hear me? The other one is service. If I cannot ignite hope in the poor and common families in Abia State, and I cannot serve, then I'm useless at all. I'm completely useless at all. That is my mandate. If you don't understand your mandate very well, you cannot fulfill it. And it is because I understand my mandate, that is why those who are still in doubt are probably thinking that I can fail as governor. It is impossible. Because it is not about me, and God has demonstrated it. For those who may not know my story, I'm the son of a poor primary school teacher. My mother was a nurse, and I became a teacher also. So if not for God, what will the son of a headmaster be doing as governor of a state? But God has raised me to tell all the poor families here that their children can become presidents also. Amen. Simple. Their children can become presidents.
Amen.
But what it takes is belief. You must believe it. You must act it. And you must make God the foundation of everything you do. Looking at the topic, leadership in the fear of God. Leadership studies and talks and discussions about leadership is a school. So I cannot pretend that I can do justice to everything you need to know about leadership. Besides that, I don't like to speak for more than 15 minutes. Even as a teacher, I speak for 30. And if anybody that you hold spare for more than 1 hour, then you must ask. Nobody can teach you about leadership. Not in the regard. Not Obama. Not Tony Blair. Not Obasanjo. Some people will say Leadership Institute. This is the biggest and greatest institute of leadership. The Holy Bible. And at this hour, I want to call your memory to two verses in the Bible. I want you to get them because somebody will read them for me. The first is Genesis chapter number 1 verse 26. You go there. The other one is Genesis chapter 22 verse 12. Up to where I would like you to stop. Before we do that, this is not my party. There is no governor here. I am Okezie Ikpeazu and I am just one of you. I am nobody before the awesome throne of God Almighty. So that nobody can say that the governor was speaking. No. God wants to speak to us. Shall we pray? Mighty Jehovah, I thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for the grace. Dear God, as I ask always, may I diminish so that your glory will ascend to heaven. Dear Lord, God, the ears of my brothers and sisters that are here. May they not see me, rather may they see you. May they see the shining light and the living light of Christ. At the end of this meeting, dear Lord, touch just one soul today. If you touch more than one, dear Lord, may all the glory be unto you. In Jesus' name I pray. Leadership in the fear of God. Can somebody read Genesis 1 verse 26 for me?
Then God said, let us make a man, someone like ourselves, to be the master of all life upon the earth and in the sky and in the sea.
Go read them. God said, let us. During the prayer of Adam in here, he very clear to us that God is self-existing. For God on creation wanted to build consensus. In some Bibles, he says, come, let us. God could have said, let there be man. But he wanted to build a consensus and he said, come, let us make man. But the awesome part of this verse of the Bible is, let us make man in our own image. I mean, if somebody says, let us make something, that is the greatest of all law. That is the greatest of all law. Because God could have made us something else and yet give us assignments and we will obey. But he said, let us make man in our own image. And he went ahead to give us command to have dominion over birds, fishes, and every other thing. That was the day leadership was entrusted in man. But I want to emphasize more, because of everything you need to be a good leader and to lead in the fear of God, there is the central role of law. Centrality of law in the paradigm of leadership, no matter how you look at it, take it up and take it down, because if there is no law, you cannot lead. So in the beginning, God said, come, let us make man in our own image. But I want to ask people here, what could it be? What is the meaning of the fear of God? Some say, Proverbs chapter 1 verse 7, the fear of God is what? The beginning of fear. Is it the kind of feeling we get when we see a cobra or a lion suddenly in the bush? Of course, you are afraid. Is that the kind of fear they are referring to? That is not the kind of fear they are referring to. If you want to know what meaning I ascribe to that fear, please. God was referring to Abraham. Abraham was asked one day to go and offer sacrifice. And then as he proceeded, he went with three people. Two of his servants, a little boy Isaac. And then, at the point, he asked the two servants to wait. And he took Isaac. As they were going, Isaac asked, Daddy, I've joined you in this journey to make sacrifice a few times. And usually, there's a lamb that accompanies us, which we eventually kill and sacrifice. I cannot see that lamb. Where is the lamb for sacrifice. Abraham called his little boy to continue. Two things are clear to you. Because if you want to understand how powerful you are as a person, you must read the greatest love story in the world, which is the story of the creation of man. God formed man from dust and bent down to kiss man, to bring life into man. I don't know, once you consider how sinful you are, how dead you are, and God came down to bring life into you. You were created to be fearful. People should be afraid of you as a child of God. You were not created to be genuflected and shaken. And that is why most of us have refused to assume leadership, even in the family. Even in the family. At times you come to a family, you will not know whether there is a man or a woman in that house. We abdicate our responsibility and what God has given us, remember, to take dominion and to put the head of serpent under our feet. All authority that we require to be leaders of our environment today is given in the Bible. So I want to remind us of the interaction between God, Abraham, and Isaac. Even as we are called to leadership today, what kind of people are we leading? The children during the time of Isaac and Samuel were more obedient than those of us that are beyond 50 now. And I don't know our experiences in our various homes with our children today, with what they are doing with internet and the kind of life they live. But we must lead them. What we see today is parents that have resigned leadership role to their children and their family. Yesterday we had a story, last week rather, of students that beheaded two other students at Abia State University. So I imagine the parents of those particular kind of children that go to school to kill other people. Isaac was an obedient child. If you take a child of 15 today and you are going to do that sacrifice, yeah, you know, look at the one trial. Yes, yeah. They may child. That's in your yard. All right. Oh, they came out 3 points up from there. Yeah, you're one man. I'm not a bad job. It's a report we're going to get. That is the kind of children we have today. But I'm not a young children in Godani, so that we can remember the law of which he created us and empowered a man. I need to tell you, Abraham powerful, I didn't know. Abraham powerful, she didn't know. There were people that contended with me in the past, they were looking at me. They did not see my God. I want to know my God. I can't remember his name, Goliath, to pray with David. More than you know you. Now, oh, yeah, God. But let's get a check. I had another one. All of this is after all for those who undermine EHD. And it also brings to memory the fact that when you are dealing with a human being, know that you are dealing with a spirit. You are dealing with something that is awesomely powerful. You are dealing with the most powerful machine. I shared a joke with my friends last week. As I was watching television somewhere, Maro, a history of Ekonvaga from Peso, from Haro to Peso, to AK-47, to machine gun, to atomic bomb, to nuclear bomb, whoever, I'm not following it again. Then I asked myself, oh yeah, Ejiyabano, or what that Ejiyabano? I said, a lot of money. So, for people make a mistake of it's a spirit. And today the attitude if we are not careful. May this not be our experience in Jesus' name. So, my brothers and sisters, since we know now that the fear of God incepted as to love God, to do his commandments, to keep his will. That is fear of God. Fear of God happened in the Bible. God made a circumference of as well as anything around it. No. Fear of God is your life, your existence every day to be a gospel, to know the legal manaya, manaya, manolo. And you cannot fear God unless you understand the law. Remember that he formed us like himself, sign of law. He bent down to kiss us, to give us breath of life, sign of law. When he created everything, he brought to us also, because he wants us to participate in creation. He wanted us to participate in taking dominion and rulership of the world. We will come to the redemption story, which is even more gruesome. But for now, every time you remember effort to Chineke in creating you, then you will know that you are not a creature in vain. Chineke aga atano, kechare, bibrela, yehumendo, only for nothing. He created each and every one of you for a purpose, and that purpose is leadership. That purpose is leadership. May your class prefect, may your Zendaya, may your family, may your choir, may your church, anywhere you find yourself, you are a leader. See, let me tell you people, children of God, what I have seen in this congregation today. Others here back, everything, we go to hell. This altar is for God of life, for here and there back. Down or deep your water. But we'll excuse over and over. Everything you require is here. Come here, I need to change your church. I need to change your church. You need to God, come on, another. It is not good. We should learn to wait on the Lord and wait on the Lord patiently. If you love God, until you get it. I never bless you. Even what happened, I was to the camera like Abraham or Job. That's what I want. Okay, you're more grateful. But that is God for you. It is written here in the Bible. For us to see how God and God will not be able to do it. But the one who will trust in Chineke, Abraham, no single example of somebody that has loved God, Chineke, that was the only one to do that. So, now, what does it take to live in the fear of God? We have said, well, Chineke, we should also learn to love God and love the It is a very, very difficult thing to lead human beings. David went after a lion because of his love for what I told you. And children are not bound to an academy. In Japan, our redemption story, when it became a problem to redeem man, we were headed to hell, all of us. We have seen the adoption of God's glory. There was a conference again in heaven. And our dear Christ said, send me. Christ came here and became man. Christ came from heaven and became man. I'm a man because on our end, we didn't see the little one again. He didn't want to have any friends. Just to leave Ekena here. Meanwhile, Ekena is like a swamp in Abuja. Abuja Ekena, I have 1 million of money. This is what for Christ left his throne for you and for me. And I'm going to put 1 million in the car. I will never need you. This thing is real and true for each and every one of us. It is personal. I will tell you one story and I will close. Over on the narrow food, fast food chair in America, I watch it. So one day, he decided. decided to go to Gabriel to that and say, I want to pass to chair and be there. To that notice, that I did have pass Africa. I went to the first branch. They took him as a training supervisor. Without knowing lawyer was coming. So yeah, I can't have anything here. I have to do this. What is the electric part? What is the better? What is the electric man? What is the electric customer? Yeah, no, I know to chat for D level and that particular branch. Yeah, come on that branch. Look at three branches. So one day, 8 days later, see, for right now, we know what happened in office. They all went to the head office. Okay, Kaya, I was that first speaker at the knee supervisor.
Yeah.